The CDC recently released new guidance for schools on how they should deal with the COVID-19 pandemic. So what did the CDC tell schools? It's up to local school districts to decide when and how to reopen, and many are doing so under existing state directives. The new federal guidance is meant to aid those efforts. It says schools should fall into four color-coded risk levels, depending on the rate of the virus within their community. When she announced the guidance, CDC Director Rochelle Walensky said that 90% of counties in the United States fall into the highest risk level. That means schools there need to take the most precautions. In that high risk level, middle and high schools may need to remain in remote learning if they can't take extensive mitigation steps, including potentially testing students and staff regularly to ensure that the virus is not spreading in their buildings. But that kind of testing is inaccessible to some schools. How is this different from previous guidance the CDC released? Under the Trump administration, the agency released several phases of guidance to schools throughout the course of the pandemic. But district administrators complained that it was confusing to read and at times contradictory. The new guidance seeks to put everything all in one place. It includes some of the recommendations that were in previous iterations, but it's far more direct. For example, the guidance suggests that masks should be required in all schools rather than recommended. It also suggests that 6 feet of social distancing is a must unless a school is in a low-risk area, which very few schools are. The guidance also suggests that schools should consider cohorting students, putting them in small groups to reduce interactions throughout the building, making it easier to trace and isolate potential exposure should it occur within the school community. What does the CDC say about vaccines? The recommendations echo those of another federal panel that said that states should prioritize teachers and school employees for early doses of the vaccine. But the CDC says schools don't need to wait to open until every employee has been vaccinated. So will this guidance help reopen schools? That's the big question. First, it's important to note that schools in many areas are already operating under some sort of in-person model, and many state leaders have advised their districts to stay the course even with the new CDC recommendations. For schools that aren't open, education groups hope that new centralized recommendations would lend more credibility to the federal response, helping them to navigate contentious debates in their own communities. But since the guidance have come out, some public health experts have said the CDC may have set the bar too high, making it difficult for schools in some areas with high infection rates to welcome students back. And some who are hesitant about school reopenings have said the guidance should have done more to address issues like ventilation, which is a big concern in dated school buildings. President Joe Biden has asked Congress for an additional $130 billion in aid for K-12 schools to help as they continue to confront the crisis. But it's likely that debates over how schools should respond, whether they're being too cautious or not cautious enough, will continue for some time. For more on COVID-19 in schools, visit edweek.org.